Guys, India just announced they plan to upskill over 5 million young Indians over the next 5 years by 2030. Guys, I don't think you understand. India is about to have a massive boom over the next decade. But don't just take my word for it. Listen to what the IBM CEO, Arvind Krishna, says. He says, quote, India possesses the talent and ambition to lead the world in AI and quantum. Fluency in frontier technologies will define economic competitiveness, scientific progress, and societal transformation. Our commitment to skill 5 million people is an investment in that future. By democratizing access to advanced skills, we are enabling the youth and students to build, innovate, and accelerate India's growth. So I want to talk about this for just a minute. If you're new here, again, my name's Mark. I cover AI in the news and how it's going to impact your world 6 days a week. Make sure you like and subscribe. But let's talk about that for just a minute. Now, listen, IBM is an American country, or an American company. And, you know, this idea that, well, we, you know, this statement here, India possesses the talent and ambition to lead the world in AI and quantum. I don't love that statement. Shouldn't the United States be leading the world? Shouldn't the United States be in the world? I'm not saying that India can't be have leaders. There's obviously a lot of Indians in big tech leading. But I don't love that statement. I feel like the statement should be the US is going to lead the world and India is going to be a strategic partner in helping us achieve that end. My opinion. Anyway, let's continue. So how does IBM plan to do it? Well, they have a couple different programs. They have the P-Tech, which is the company's program for high school learners, and they have their Skills Build program, which is an open access platform for tech learning material and certificate programs. But what I think you also need to understand about this IBM upskilling initiative is that this skill program is only a small portion of the entire upskilling plan. Now, the company has a goal to train 30 million people worldwide. And again, they've been pretty clear on how they plan to do that within India. But what again is kind of surprising with IBM is they haven't been clear on how they plan to upskill in the United States. You know, they've said that they plan to upskill Americans, but the best estimate I can get is 2 million Americans by 2030. I'm just kind of curious as to why IBM is being so specific about their plans in India, but not in the United States. It's kind of a question mark to me. Regardless, IBM definitely sees a huge future in India, but they're not the only ones, guys. Microsoft has committed $17.5 billion on AI infrastructure in India, and they plan to upskill 20 million Indians over the next 5 years. And we covered that at length in this video. If you want to know more about how Microsoft is planning on upskilling and how they're committed to India, definitely click on this video and check that out. Guys, I don't think people fully understand this. And by the way, I've been talking about this for several years. I read Tim Ferriss's The 4-Hour Workweek about 7 years ago, and I immediately started working with people overseas. That was his kind of big thing is, hey, if you make, you know, for what you could hire someone here in the United States to do for $10, you can find someone in overseas who will do it for $3 or $4, right? So you can get a lot more bang for your buck, so to speak. And I work with people all over the world, Philippines, India, Serbia, Bangladesh, Pakistan, Argentina, Germany. If you name the country, I probably worked with someone in that country. And I will say that there are strengths and weaknesses with working with people that are not in the United States. I'll talk about that here in just a moment. But regardless, I think what people don't fully understand is how much the Indian ecosystem is booming now and will boom over the next 10 years. Guys, in 2025, get this, the startup funding surpassed over $10 billion across 1,200 deals. People are investing in India. They are investing in India. They've seen a 15% year-over-year growth in sectors like healthcare and fintech, which, by the way, are two of the hottest sectors when it comes to AI development and AI innovation. But again, you know, we talked a little bit about IBM's investment in India, Microsoft, $17.5 billion, but Amazon, $35 billion, Google, $10 billion. All the big tech companies are going really hard in the paint in India. It's just, it's good. I don't think people fully understand how big this is going to be. Some estimates predict that there will be 4 million new AI jobs created in India by 2030. And I don't have any reason to doubt that number. No reason to doubt that number based on what I've seen in the past. And even HSBC is very, very bullish on Asia, particularly India. I saw this in a CNBC article earlier today. Now, listen, here's the deal. We live in, guys, we live in a global world. We live in a global economy, and you know, the H-1B visa program has had an intense scrutiny against it. And I'm still trying to wrap my head around this, guys, because this is it's a big deal. It impacts a lot of us, the H-1B visa program. And frankly, I liked Trump's idea of the $100,000 application fee. I love the idea of checking out social media accounts to make sure they're not anti-freedom, anti-free speech. There's a lot of very angry people out there that probably aren't a good fit for the American experiment. But my stance is, if you're up for the American experiment, you want to build a family, you want to subscribe to the values that we hold dear in the United States, then let's go. Let's freaking go. Let's make this next century the century that the United States improves and uplifts the world as a whole. But here's the deal. The problem, guys, is that if we cut off all the H-1B visas, you know, companies are going to offshore. Because the big, I think, problem that we've seen with the H-1B visa program is the idea that it undercuts wages. People say, oh, well, I can get 5 developers in India for the cost of 1 developer in the United States. And that's not great. That's not great. That's not fair to Americans. Frankly, it's not fair to Indians either. But if we cut off the H-1B visa program, well, companies are just going to offshore. All this software development work can be done remotely. I mean, the companies that I'm building out, basically everybody is remote. We're not all meeting in the same office. They're all remote. So, you know, there has to be a reason to hire American if that's the case. And I don't like the government stepping in and overregulating. I think free markets, you got to let the free markets work. You got to let supply and demand work. Again, complicated. It's complicated. Because the reality is, guys, if we cut ourselves off from the world and we say, we're only going to develop the technology here in the United States, we're cutting ourselves off at the knees. The world is an amazing place with many beautiful places, with vast resources and many different people with many different skills. And to cut ourselves off and say, we're just going to be US-based, I feel like we cut ourselves off at the knees. I mean, there's got to be a balance. And to be straight, I am America first. But we can't just say it America only. That to me doesn't make sense. We have to be part of the global ecosystem. That's how we grow. We're stronger together. And I'm not talking about some weird, wonky DEI equity crap. I'm saying, hey, let's bring all the smartest people together to build the best systems to uplift humankind as a whole. At least that's my stance. And the reality, guys, is I'm in the same shoes as most of you. 42 years old, work hard. I'm in marketing. I do a lot of digital content. You can see me creating content here on YouTube daily. I'm competing against Indians and Filipinos and people all over the seas just as much as anybody else. I'm competing against India and AI just as much as anybody else. But there are things that I know I can lean into. I can lean into human-to-human connection. I can lean into the relationships that I have. I can lean into leadership skills. I can lean into understanding the context and the way that Americans communicate with one another. I know I can lean into that, hey, I'm not gonna get it done tomorrow. I'm gonna stay up till midnight tonight and I'm gonna get it done today. I can lean on better connection. And by the way, someone in that Microsoft video, shout out to all the guys that watched that video and girls. One of the comments someone made was, hey, Mark, if I wanted to get hired by you or a company that you work with, what would you be looking for? Guys, it's communication above all. The worst thing you can do when you, and this is something, again, I'm going to go off on a little bit of a tangent here. One of the problems that I've run into quite a bit with working with overseas people is they don't communicate quickly. I'll send a message and I don't get a response back for 24, 48, 72 hours. That is not acceptable. I cannot work with people like that. I will not work with people like that. If I send you a message, I need a response back that same day. And the response doesn't need to be some well, long, thought out response, but at least let me know, hey, I got the message. You want to get hired and you want to stay hired and you want to be successful in a remote world, you got to be able to respond quickly. Again, just saying, hey, got it. Imagine if your wife was texting you and you just ignored all of her texts for 2 days. You're not going to be married much longer, guys. This is coming from someone who's been married for over a decade. Regardless, I digress. Here's the bottom line, guys. India's not going anywhere. India is about to boom. AI is not going anywhere. AI is about to impact every single facet of your life. So this is not the time to be in denial about that, and to be angry and upset and give up hope. Now's the time to say, how can I leverage this knowledge to my advantage? How can I leverage this knowledge to remain relevant, respected, and financially free in a rapidly changing world? Guys, if you enjoyed today's video, you definitely want to check out yesterday's video. Crazy what's happening. People are getting married to ChatGPT bots left and right. Watch yesterday's video. Thanks for being here. Catch you there. Peace.